Bellingham, Washington is a peaceful spot now, but it won't be for long if a group of powerful corporations get their way. 18 times a day, massive coal trains from Peabody Energy's mines could soon roll through town to and from a proposed coal port. From there, it would be loaded onto ships bound for China's coal-burning power plants, a vast new source of climate-altering carbon emissions. Environmentalist Ross McFarlane shows the direction the corporations want to go.
Moving from the largest coal fields in the United States and some of the largest in the world here in eastern Montana and Wyoming, put it on rail, ship it through communities in Montana, northern Idaho, and Washington to a facility just north of Bellingham at a place called Cherry Point.
This is Cherry Point today, a rich marine ecosystem.
If the proposal goes ahead as planned, this stretch of coastline will become the largest coal port in North America, shipping out 45 million metric tons every year.
Environmentalists say pollution from the BNSF rail cars owned by multi-billionaire Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway conglomerate could destroy the ecosystem.
This entire intertidal area is at risk of being blanketed with coal dust during spawning season. We see salmon depending on these beach spawning fish, orcas dependent on salmon, our tourist industry, our fisheries. All those things are actually threatened by the potential impact of this coal terminal on this Cherry Point reach.
But with demand for coal flat in the U.S., coal, rail, and shipping interests are anxious to push into new markets in Asia. SSA Marine, whose parent company is 49% owned by Goldman Sachs, operates the Port of Seattle and would also build and operate the proposed coal port.
If we don't export it, someone else will. And it's a good opportunity to take advantage of a resource that exists in our country and helps our balance of trade.
Bellingham resident Julie Trimmingham is organizing her neighbors against the coal port, saying the trains will bring noise, pollution, and congestion to the town.
I love this area, and I'm protective of this area and the beauty and the spirit and the ethos of this particular region. And it is my backyard, but I would also say that our backyard now is the world.
The project is now beginning a multi-year environmental review process before federal, state, and local government authorities decide whether to approve or reject it. Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera, Bellingham, Washington.